Buffalo Bills taking on Mac Jones and the New England Patriots.
Ah, yes, nothing quite like Buffalo in January as we welcome you inside a snowy Bills stadium on the shores of Lake Erie. A few moments ago, to the delight of this Buffalo crowd, it was the Bills racing out of the tunnel as they get set to match up with the New England Patriots. Taylor now from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. So here come the Patriots getting ready on offense. They'll be led by the Heisman finalist from a season ago, the rookie from Alabama, Mac Jones.
Mac Jones absolutely believed in himself coming out of high school. Went to Alabama despite the fact there are many high-profile quarterbacks already on the roster and blossomed into a Heisman Trophy candidate in his final season with 41 touchdowns and only 4 interceptions. Steady, consistent as a passer, doesn't have the biggest cannon for an arm, but can stretch the field and lay those passes in on the deep ball.
First carry now for Ramondre Stevenson.
And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Jones.
The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Oh, that was a pretty route right there, because it's all about finding a window on a route like that. He lined up on his left, ran the deep in route over the middle, and the ball was right where it needed to be. Really good trust between quarterback and receiver. Really good completion.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 48-yard line. Throwing Jones. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Out of the gun, they give it to Stevenson. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with 3rd and 9 looming.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. Looking to throw. Jones. Hunter Henry brings it in. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Jones on first down. He gets this one to Johnson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Well, this has certainly been a nice drive with the way they've spread the football around. Here, they even get the fullback involved in the passing game. That's got to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You've got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. They'll run with a former member of the Crimson Tide, Damian Harris. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Working with a second and 4. On the draw is Stevenson. Powers through. He pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
8th play of this opening drive coming up. This is 3rd down. Back to throw. Jones. Touchdown, Patriots! Hunter Henry from 6 yards away. And the Patriots have taken the early lead on the road here in Buffalo. They gotta love that. 9-play drive results in 6 points.
That means they're doing the dictating. That means that they've described how the game's going to go. They're playing at their tempo, at their pace. If you're on the other side of the ball, if you're playing defense, defense is not methodical. They've got to go in there and shake things up and create a little havoc.
Nick Folk for the point after. Now, these are not going to be easy on a cold, snowy night, but this one is up and through. That time, a 9-play drive, and it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Isaiah McKenzie now on the return. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Out comes the offense for the Bills, led by their quarterback at 6'5". That's Josh Allen.
And in this league, there are many quarterbacks who have their most success running the ball, while there are others who have big arms. There aren't too many guys who can do both. And at the end of many games, this guy leads his team not just in passing, but in rushing as well.
Allen and the Bills now with a 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now the first carry for Devin Singletary. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's 2nd down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Here's Allen. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Juwan Bentley. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. Well, certainly not how he wanted to start his night. First throw of the game, an INT.
Yeah, it's not easy, but he's got to try and wipe that one away from the memory banks. And let's face it, it's not often a quarterback and a defensive back have a lot in common. But one thing, because they have these individual type plays, they've got to have short memories, don't they? DB gets beat, wipe it away, quarterback throws a pick, has to do the same thing.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Play action, Jones. And that'll be complete to Stevenson. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one. Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
To throw on second and 10. Jones, this one to Bourne out on the left side. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Again, he'll drop to throw. Throw it across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And the Bills are going to get the football back at their own 17. That pick hurts a little extra because it was third down. You were already in field goal range.
You know what he's going to hear all night, all next week? Situational football. Understand what's going on, because you expressed it perfectly. 3 points were in their hip pocket. They had those. Now, those went by the wayside. You cannot make those kind of mistakes.
It's what you call a rookie mistake. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And Diggs has it. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man. Maybe needs some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
On first down, Allen. And a catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Now, that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To the air, Allen. And once again, this is Sanders. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
My goodness, they've come out locked in on this drive. Play calling, execution, they are fully in sync. Three straight passes, three first downs. They're moving the ball downfield almost at will. This defense really struggling to find answers.
Again, they'll throw with Allen. The Sanders has got it complete. 7 yards, the pickup there. Well, that's now four completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Allen gonna throw. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Allen. And his throw's gonna be incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well and that one's incomplete.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. Here's Allen to throw it. Throwing for his running back, and he's got it complete. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. Tyler Bass out for the Bills field goal. It'll come from the right hash. It's a 47-yard attempt. The kick by Bass is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the turnover leads to points as they add three there.
Yeah, what a sequence there, and a nice one for them. They forced the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
So after knocking through the field goal, here's Bass to kick it away. On the return is J.J. Taylor. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Here comes Mac Jones and the rest of the Patriot offense. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for them, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
Harris starts the drive on the ground, and he powers his way up past the 30. A.J. Klein on the tackle there.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Again, it's Harris on second down. And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. On the give, this is Harris. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Still nine remaining on second down. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Jones hit and the ball's out. I always hear a lot of veterans on the defensive side of the football. They talk about smelling blood in the water, putting pressure on a rookie. They got to him there to force it free, but couldn't recover him.
And you mentioned the pressure. Rookie quarterback, you're going to bring more pressure to him at all times because you don't know how he's going to hold up. He was fortunate there. Luck was on his side, able to recover that fumble.
So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Looking to throw. Jones. That's caught. Left side. Myers with it. And he gets this only to the 41. Not near enough for the first. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. The Patriots send out their punter. Isaiah McKenzie is back deep for the Bills. This is taken at the 15. This will be a 41-yard punt, 3 on the return. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. Allen and the Bills now with a 1st and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Allen. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's 2nd down.
And with a dime look on defense, 2 extra defensive backs on the field have covered up essentially every blade of grass. That's allowed them to disrupt the play.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. To throw, it's Allen. On a slant, he's got Sanders. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Now Allen. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. They'll run on 1st down with Singletary. And he'll take it across the 50 and into New England territory. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Right back to Singletary on second down. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. Now looks to throw, rolling to his right. Allen hit, he lost the football, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Thank goodness for heaters up here, and thank goodness I don't have to carry the football in this game. It's January, it's cold out there. Trying to clutch the football and absorb the hits, not easily done.
Yeah, we saw a product of the elements right there. So the Patriots coming out now. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and give these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Very good starting position for the Patriot offense as they come up first and 10 at their 38. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. They hand this off to Harris, and he'll only get a yard, maybe 2, up to the 46. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
New England on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. They're up against a third and 1 situation. Complete. It's Henry. And he will have a Patriots first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on third and 2.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Jones on first and 10, looking for Aguilar. It's intercepted. Picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. So a dangerous pass over the middle into zone coverage, and it bit him hard.
And what's really difficult when you throw it in that direction and versus that zone, that means the linebackers have gotten to their spot, gotten their heads back around, and they can see the quarterback and everything in front of them. And they took big advantage of it, went in the other direction, excellent blocking, and picked up a touchdown.
Now the try here for the extra point. It's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Taylor now to return it. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
in. But they told him, and they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Jones throw there taken in by Smith. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. On second down now, it's Harris. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Jones now throwing on first down, and they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. And now following the incomplete pass, we'll get a timeout here for an injured player. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw again, Jones. And right side, Henry's got it. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
New England on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. 46 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
They run with Harris. Tackle made there by Matt Milano.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They'll try the right side with Harris. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
That was well played there defensively. 2 tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 8. Back to throw. Jones. Oh, Jones has just thrown his 3rd interception. Teron Johnson able to pick it. There he goes, right side. And he is going to score. It's a pick 6 and a Bills touchdown. third down, passing down. They throw the extra defensive back in there for a nickel package, and it worked out.
And it's not anything that you would think is just great strategy. It's just that when you have five defensive backs on the field on an obvious passing down, it's a lot tougher to complete a pass. And on that play, they completed it just to the wrong team, and it cost them 6 points.
Tyler Bass now for the point after. It's good to make it 17-7. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. On the return, it's Taylor. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here comes Mac Jones and the rest of the Patriot offense. So with the three interceptions, how does he erase those from his mind and just focus on this drive?
I think he may need some help from the coaching staff. Maybe the offensive coordinator says, okay, let's do a few of the shorter throws, quick rhythm throws where the ball's out of his hand quickly into a receiver before the defense can react. Maybe not take so many shots downfield, just in case. Get your confidence back up, and then later on, you expand the targets again.
The kiss method, keep it simple, stupid, right?
I love it. I love it.
They'll run with Stevenson to begin the drive. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. They'll run on first down. It's Harris. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up five, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
On second down, it's Stevenson. And he's going to get forward for about five, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee? Offense. That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Off the play fake, Jones. It's caught by Aguilar. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty.
Fired that one in there, able to make a connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. Here's Jones from the gun on third down.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. third and short. Blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 47. Looking to throw. Jones completes it to Aguilar. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30.
I tell you what, it looks like he's shaking off that pick six just fine. It's not just defensive backs that have to have short memories. Quarterbacks utilize that as well. A much more confident throw right there.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder coming up at halftime, while the two of us head for warmer areas of the press box, we'll be sending you to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half.
Meanwhile, Jones' throw there complete to Myers.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
Well, they obviously read man coverage their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him
think.
What
do you mean by that?
He made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and then he curls back inside for the completion.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Myers. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 3 yards the gain there, second down. They'll look to throw again. Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sacked back at the 29. Jerry Hughes too strong as he's in for the sack. This offense continues to shoot themselves in the foot. And here, another sack.
All game long, we've seen missed assignments, which have led to turnovers, sacks. This group has not played well at all here in the first half.
Work now for Jones and the Patriots here after the sack. It's third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Setting up a screen for Stevenson. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Patriots will bring on the field goal unit. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. And Folks' kick is good. And they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. So the 3 points there, and CD, that helps them inch a bit closer.
Yeah, partner, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
After the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Bills going to take over now late in this first half. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue. Thank you.
first down is Allen. He'll buy some time right. And Allen will have the first down as he's able to slide to avoid the contact at the end. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. So the shotgun snap to Allen. He's got the connection to Cole Beasley. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
And meanwhile, Allen's throw taken in by Diggs. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. First down. And that nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Well, fortunate to retain possession there, and it's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now Allen going to give it to Moss. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. It's a gain of a couple on what should be the final carry of half number one. So we've reached halftime here in Orchard Park with the Bills taking the lead into the break. As we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. The snow certainly making conditions difficult, and it's not likely to get better anytime soon, as we turn it right back over to Brandon and Charles.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. Since we left you at halftime, the snow still continuing to fall as we are back underway. Taken at the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. Out come the Bills now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. And Charles, they've got the lead. I would imagine the overall halftime tone was a positive one, but what do you think the talking points were in the locker room?
Well, there were three talking points at the half, partner. All of them were about turnovers because they were pretty loose with the ball. Otherwise, this lead could be even bigger. Now, I don't think that they overly harped on it, but I think they told them, guys, if you want to keep calling those plays that are exciting, you've got to take care of the ball. Otherwise, we may have to dial things back a little bit.
The third quarter starts with a run by Singletary, and he'll take it forward for about 5 up to the 28-yard line. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Second down at 5. Singletary again. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
The Patriots going with a dime package here. Two extra defensive backs on third. Throwing now is Allen. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Mills. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind, and we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
With every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Off play action, Jones. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. The delay of game backs him up five, first and 15. From the gun, Jones. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide, because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the third row.
Behind the sticks here with a second and 15. From the gun, it's Stevenson. 5 yards will get them back to the original line of scrimmage, but now they're looking at third and 10.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Now Jones to throw on third down. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Jerry Hughes, his second sack of the night. And you get the feeling, Charles, yeah, he's got the two sacks now, but he may get more here. We still got a quarter and then some to go.
And the way that he is playing this game, it reminds me of one of the best golfers in the world who can use every club in the bag and make a great shot. That's what he's doing with his pass rush moves right now, showing a little bit of everything. They have no way of stopping him.
And for the second time tonight, his field goal unit comes out here. Wind at his back now in this third quarter. And Fultz's kick is good. And that will cut this lead back down to four now. It's 17-13. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. Returning it, Isaiah McKenzie. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Back now on offense, the Buffalo Bills. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. On first down, they'll start out with Singletary. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe it'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Second and eight coming up. Now Allen. This is brought in by the tight end, Tommy Sweeney. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Here's Allen on first and 10, eluding the pressure right. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Second down and 3. Allen going to give this one to Singletary, and he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
From midfield, here's Allen. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Marching in for the sack, Matthew Judon.
Well, he shot in, CD, like he was out of a cannon from that linebacker position. And even though they had a running back in the backfield, no one could stop him.
Well, you certainly diagnosed that play perfectly, because as fast as he got into the backfield, you're exactly right. The running back had no shot to get over and try and protect his quarterback, and a sack resulted.
Well behind the sticks here with a second and 18. Singletary here running out of the gun. He was able to pick up 6 yards there, so that leaves him with a third and 13.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On third and long, it's Allen. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
He just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 38. Operating from the gun. Allen. And that one off the mark behind him. Incomplete.
They always say that real estate is about location. Well, guess what? When it's a slant route, the quick ones, timing, timing, timing. Got to be able to lead your man with the football.
And the timing off right there. Threw it behind him. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. He'll let this thing go for Sanders. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Emmanuel Sanders, 38 yards. And the Bills will add on to their lead. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you've taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
The point after, no gimme in the snow, but it's up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Taylor now to return it. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. New England's offense set to go. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder, puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. They'll start on the ground with Harris. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. From the gun, Jones. Got the connection here to Bourne. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, but he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, and that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
Stevenson now on first and 10. And they're going to stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Now a give, right side, Harris. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Jones on third down. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
So, first and 10 now in Buffalo territory, right at the 40. Out of the gun, they give it to Stevenson. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
From the 38, Jones. It's caught on the right side at Smith. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of four.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. Now Jones. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And as a quarterback, you're always pleased when you can use all the weapons at your disposal. Here he spots his fullback underneath, gets the completion right there for a nice pickup.
Jones. Henry's got it out on the left side. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism. Great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Needing 2 yards on second down. A give to Harris. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 67 yards on the ground for him now as he's done that on 15 carries. Now, yes, a two-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a two-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
Tackling's obviously critical down near the goal line. That was great work there to make the hit behind the line and make sure he doesn't get any further. Did a really nice job wrapping up and not letting him loose.
Back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. On the ground, it's Harris. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought,
yeah,
is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing.
And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down. So let's sort this out. And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty. No question there.
You don't think they spent a couple of seconds mulling over what the penalty would
do for them? I don't even know why they asked the sideline.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving.
Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. They'll try and throw for it. And this is caught. They got it. And that could be an important 2 points that gets them back within a field goal. So they go with the pass, and it works there on the two-point try. Charles, just in general, what are your thoughts, passing versus running on two-point conversion? Situational?
It is situational, and you have to know your team. What is your strength? Because so many people think you have to throw the ball in a two-point conversion, but the stats will tell you that running it is about as proficient. So know your team and go to your strength.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Buffalo offense back out, ready to go. I don't want to say that they're completely against the wall here, Charles, but all of a sudden, with the run that they've been on the other sideline, this is down to a 3-point game. They got to be careful.
Not much space from their back to the wall, though. So you're exactly right. They've got to be careful here. But this is where the value of note-taking and recall comes into play. What was working earlier? Why was it working? Can you get those types of matchups again? And can you run those plays that'll get you a little bit more breathing room and a little bit of space?
On the move to his left. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play. Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold him for a short gain when he took off running.
From the 22, Allen. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
The offense on third down tonight, they've only converted once in four tries. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. A quick throw going to be caught by Diggs. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that certainly appears to be a critical conversion right there, because not only do they keep the drive going, they take valuable time off the clock as well. They have to feel really good about that last completion.
So into Pats territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Here's Allen. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And they finally put an end to this return, but not before he's all the way down to the 37. A critical error there in a tight game in the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter, turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
Scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Throwing to start the drive, Jones. And he will find his man on the end route, complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
Well, we can talk about it like it's just a basic route, but how about the timing on this one? Lined up on the right, runs a deep in route. And how about the throw? Right on the money. Bam, puts it right in there and on his hands. Nice completion. Really good pickup.
And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
He was trying to get that one out to his running back out of the backfield, but that one was read and timed perfectly, and they were able to break it up.
Here's second and 10. Throwing again, Jones. Throw left side, complete. That's Stevenson. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out.
An extra defensive back here for the Bills on third down. Back to throw again.
He'll get this into the hands of Stevenson.
And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
Boy, that one was well read defensively. And this is all about diagnosis as a safety and being decisive, because he saw it setting up in front of him, able to knife through there and make the play.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. Right hash, 37-yard attempt. And Folks' kick is good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. Well, you talk about clutch. That one was right down Broadway, and this game's all even here in the fourth.
Yeah, he didn't leave any doubt, did he? Good snap, good hold, dead center. almost like a big-time golfer in a major, firing at a pin from the fairway, trying to win the tournament going down the stretch.
Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. McKenzie returning it. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. And now out come the Bills. Well, the bad news, they had the turnover last time. The good news, their defense only surrendered three. So now we are set up for a great finish, all tied here in the fourth. And the Bills now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Kyle Van Noy able to get him down behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of a yard.
We've seen him escape similar situations earlier in the game and get away for pretty good yardage. At that time, they get him down.
Yeah, they've had enough evidence that he can get away and run for good yardage, haven't they? That time it felt like, okay, enough of this. Let's play it the right way and get him on the ground before he does any damage.
Second and 11 now. A give, Singletary right side. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
The Bills on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and 5. Back to throw. Allen working the middle here. That's complete to Knox, the tight end. And he is going to have a Bills first down. They needed 4. He doubled that. He wound up getting 8.
The tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On the give, this is Singletary. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
From the 41, Allen and Beasley with it over the middle.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on first and 10. Play action, now it's Allen. He'll go right back to Beasley. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 36. A quick throw taken in by Diggs. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars. And he came through with a nice catch right there.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
They'll give this to Singletary running right. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. It was Matt Judon that time who worked his way in to blow that play up.
As a linebacker, you're taught to stay just slightly behind the ball carrier just in case he makes a cutback. But when you find the gap, shoot it. And he found it all right. Took it straight into the backfield and made the tackle for a loss.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. They face a second down, but they are in field goal range. Right back to Singletary on second down. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. They lose two on that last play, so things get even tougher. Third and long coming up.
Partner, you got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here. A pair of negative running plays, and now they're looking up at a third down at 17 to go. On the handoff, it's Singletary. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts, as it'll come with an even 90 seconds remaining on the clock. Bit of a pressure spot here for Tyler Bass. This for the lead in the final stages. The kick by Bass is good. And they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes. Big kick right there to give them the lead in the fourth, but there is still time left for a final drive.
Did they score too soon? Post-game will tell us, right? Depending on what happens on this drive, that's how we'll analyze it. If the other team scores, they scored too soon. If they somehow hold on, they manage the clock exactly right.
So after knocking through the field goal, here's Bass to kick it away. On the return, it's Taylor. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. So now Jones and the Patriots. Down 27-24, a little over 80 ticks to go. They need at minimum 3 points out of this as they come up first and 10. Jones. Throw's going to be incomplete.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here's Jones. His throw incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, now third and 10. And first things first, before you think about marching the ball down the field, you got to move the chains.
You're exactly right. Got to get back into focus here. Get the first down. That's what's vital to them.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Jones. And he
can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. Now Jones. He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And boy, possession here turns over with the football already being in the red zone. Buffalo set to get the football back here. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
The Bills on their way to victory now as they take the knee. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as it comes with exactly a minute to go in the football game. The Bills on their way to victory now as they take the knee. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Allen down to a knee, and that should just about do it.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So it's a victory here for the Buffalo Bills. And you've got to say, CD, it was the defense who had a big part in the W.
Not without question. When you force four turnovers, you get to enjoy the spoils of victory, don't you? It's rare that you force four turnovers and lose a ball game. That's almost unheard of. They carried this one home. He talked about celebrating with each other and being in a position where going forward, all you think about is, let's get five next time. They're going to be on the hunt.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hardworking men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we say good night from Buffalo.